So have you ever wondered, why Google Ad Exchange accounts approvals are difficult to get? Why doesn't Google provide you with Google Ad Exchange account? Now you are actually making them thousands of dollars. You claim that you're making this much amount of money, and still approval is a pain. So I'll help you understand why that is the case. Also, you must have wondered, you're making tens and thousands of dollars for these particular resellers. Why don't they respond to you? So ideally, you're making money for them, but why don't these resellers respond to you despite making tens of thousands of dollars? So we'll be answering these important questions, and I'll help you understand why it is so difficult to get a Google Ad Exchange account. Also, I'll be covering ad loading. So ad loading is an easy hack to make, more money. It's being used and abused a lot by publishers, specifically in the Asian market, I would say, Indian, Pakistani, Bangladeshi, and even, Nigerian publishers do ad loading. So for the rest who aren't aware of what ad loading is, I'll cover ad loading. And for the Indian publishers, please do watch it, because I'll tell you why you should not consider doing ad loading. There are a lot of YouTubers who have already told you, do ad loading, you can easily make quick money, reach out to me, I'll help you do ad loading. I'll help you understand what's the impact of ad loading on the overall digital marketing and overall publisher market, and how it's impacting us. Lastly, for the publishers who don't do ad loading but still rely on arbitrage, but they struggle to keep their ad exchange accounts approved, their ad exchange accounts get blacklisted. So in this particular video, I will be letting you know how you can keep yourself safe and how you can actually do arbitrage safely. Now, arbitrage is something that is legal, and this is not unlike ad loading. Ad loading is simply, I would say, it's sort of a theft that you're doing for the advertisers. So my job in this particular video tutorial, either you're doing ad loading or arbitrage, or you're not doing that, is firstly to keep you safe and then to help you make more money from your Google Ad Exchange account. And I'll also let you know what is the right path to make more money, what is the sustained path that you can use to make money consistently using Google Ad Exchange. All in all, it will again be a detailed and yet impactful video tutorial for you. So why are Ad Exchange MA accounts difficult to get? So the criteria basically to get a Google Ad Exchange account for most of the resellers is, if you're making anywhere between 5K USD, you should be easily able to get your Google Ad Exchange account. And something other than that they need is you should have organic presence, and you should not be doing like 100% arbitrage. Now, I would come to this later on, because when you're doing 100% arbitrage, there's more of a risk that you are prioritizing, the monetization over the quality of user experience. So this happens when you do a lot of arbitrage, and that is the reason why resellers don't prefer using this. But you guys will be like, I do not have such traffic. I just paid 5K or 10K to someone, some YouTuber, and he helped me get a Google Ad Exchange account. Now, there are only few companies that are involved in such unethical practices, and they are able to provide you Ad Exchange MA accounts without vetting. But sooner or later, their MCM membership is likely to get canceled. So why does that happen? Google actually maintains an IVT score for each and every reseller. So if you are a reseller that has got a lot of publishers who are involved in ad loading, lot of arbitrage, so sooner or later your IVT increases, this generates flags within Google system, and your reseller membership gets canceled. I wanted to explain this to you because I get requests from a lot of small scale publishers who simply use arbitrage and ad loading. They do not have any organic presence, and they are after, ad exchange account. So I actually work with only affiliated resellers, and I do not involve in actually selling of ad exchange account for money. So I would not be able to help you with your ad exchange accounts if you do not have organic presence. If you have organic presence, I would be surely be able to help you with MI or MA account. Now, you know, this is also the reason that these resellers like Alright Media or Game Ad Zone never respond to their user queries, because you know they are just unethically providing you with Google Ad Exchange account. For them, they cannot actually reach out to Google on behalf of you to escalate important issues. That is the reason they just provide you with Ad Exchange's account, and that's it. You know, you are left to your own, and you can make as much money as you can. If you involve in any unethical practices, your account is likely to get disapproved. Now, I would recommend that you watch this video, because I would tell you what are the things that you can do to ensure that you are safe and, you know, your ad exchange account never gets disapproved. Now, let's come to the most important topic that we have for today's video, that is ad loading. So what exactly is ad loading? It means that you are artificially inflating the value of impressions and clicks, and you know you are actually getting more CPMs out of this transaction. Now, how do you actually do this? How do you do ad loading? So there are like a couple of ways by which you can do ad loading. One thing that is, you know, you can buy bot traffic. So by buying bot traffic, I mean that, you know, you'll go in with certain websites, and you know, whether it's like sparktraffic.com or TrafficBot or Traffic Creator, you'll go in on these websites and you will buy in, you know, bot traffic. But regardless of the legitimacy of the website, they'll tell you that they are giving you real traffic, but for you know, Google, it's fairly easier to detect if a larger portion of traffic comes only from these sources. You know why? Let me tell you why. So even if they are using legitimate softwares, and you know, these companies sometimes do legitimate use of softwares, and they are able to bypass the scanning systems, but where does this system fail? If you use bot traffic completely, for instance, on like, you know, more than 50-60% of your traffic, then, you know, inside Google Analytics, your traffic source becomes quite evident. So bot traffic would be reflected as either referral or direct traffic, and it's quite easier enough to identify. So if ever you are considering of buying bot traffic, you should only buy it in very less percentage compared to your overall traffic. So never let it exceed beyond 10 to 20% of your traffic, and that is how you can ensure that you stay safe. Let's now come to other things that can help you do ad loading. So this is called ClickFarms. So for those of you who aren't aware of what ClickFarms are, so very simply, you know, these are jobs that you get contacted to, and you are literally hiring individuals to click on your ads. So yeah, you know, got this right. People, you know, literally hire individuals, and their job is simple. Their job is simply monotonous, and all they need to do is actually click on several ads, view certain videos, and they get paid for it. Now, you know, you must have also encountered such jobs, because you know these jobs are spamming across the market. Today itself, while you know recording this video, I got approached for a particular job that was offering me again you know, opportunity to click on the ads. So I am aware that it relates to, you know, basically Google Ad Exchange ad loading or ad loading of other exchanges. But still, I actually, you know, proceeded to talk with that lady and still, you know, just signed up for the job. But yeah, they will ask you to complete certain tasks. But very simply, what they're trying to do is they're trying to ensure, or they're trying to trick the Google system, and they're trying to mix, you know, ClickFarms, that is legitimate users, with the bot traffic. Now, how can you know advertisers detect whether the traffic is coming from ClickFarms? Now, detecting ClickFarms is actually a tricky process, and you know that's why it is actually used in a lot. But eventually, if you are actually hiring individuals to interact with the ads, even though they'll actually interact with the ads, they will not convert into legitimate customers. So this is again something that you know you should be aware of. And if advertisers have any conversion oriented campaigns with ClickFarms, it will perform poorly. So again, you can you know supplement ClickFarms with your bot traffic, but keep in mind that you know bot traffic should be not more than 10 to 20%. ClickFarms can be another 10%, but again, mix them with your organic traffic, otherwise you're likely to get caught soon and your ad exchange account would get blacklisted. Now coming to proxy traffic. Now using proxy traffic, you can generate traffic from countries that you don't belong. So what do I mean by that? Now you'll use a proxy server and you know you will simulate a user from you know United States. That again would be a ClickFarm user, but you know using that ClickFarm user, you'll simulate an user transaction from a particular country, that is United States or any other tier one country, and that is how you utilize proxy traffic. So only proxy traffic is used in ad loading to get traffic mainly from the tier one countries to increase your ad ECPMs. Now you know proxy traffic, earlier you know people used to use VPN traffic, but VPN traffic right now is easily detectable, and if you use a lot of it, again your account is likely to get you know blacklisted. But if you use proxy traffic, again keep in mind the percentage of the traffic you're using. So again, proxy traffic, don't let it exceed beyond 5 to 10%. And I see specific instances wherein you know a site is related to Pakistan or Bangladesh, and you know they are bringing traffic from United States. So you know, please keep in mind that it should not be obvious enough for anyone that you are doing ad loading. So you know, I saw a site, and you know I've also made a case study on it. So later on, while working on this site, I realized that this publisher is doing ad loading. I wasn't aware of it earlier, but with that publisher, it was quite easily evident. Why? Because you know they had a site that actually listed menus in Pakistan, and they had a great percentage of US traffic. So right now, the publisher had you know a significant amount of percentage of search traffic. So you know they were not getting caught, and you know they were still being able to do ad loading. But keep that in mind to you know not make the mistake that this publisher is also using. If you want to buy in US traffic, ensure that you're buying traffic on the content that is global and that can attract foreign audience. Again, it should not be obvious. So yeah, this is how ad loading is done. You actually keep in mind you know mixing in right elements, and you know if you get it slightly wrong, there's a high probability of your account getting de-blacklisted. Now coming to the fourth and another step wherein you know ad loading is done. So you incentivize clicking. Now you know these meme pages or these you know certain Facebook groups wherein you know certain people control a lot of audiences, what they'll do is they'll simply ask them to actually view their websites. This again is a good way of doing actually ad loading, because pool of audiences increases and it gets difficult for the Google system to derive you know whether this is a true audience or this is you know ad loading coming into picture. Now some important things for you to keep in mind while using ad loading. Trust me, no amount of ad loading is safe, and you know regardless of any YouTuber telling you that I will show you 100% safe way of actually doing ad loading, it doesn't exist. If you want to do ad loading, you're always at risk of actually, you know, suspending your Google Ad Exchange account. And that is again a reason a lot of small publishers keep getting their ad exchange account disapproved, and they keep on getting back to, you know, me or other YouTubers. One very important tip that I wanted to share with you while doing ad loading is kindly refrain from using blogger URLs. Now it becomes quite evident that if you use a blogger URL and you are generating income beyond like $1,000 or $2,000, it becomes quite evident that you are using ad loading. So, you know, kindly refrain from doing this, otherwise your ad exchange account is likely to get suspended soon. So the catch for using ad loading is always ensure that you use it in certain percentages only to inflate your ad eCPM. Then, you should also be focusing on your SEO traffic a lot. So if your site has 50 to 60% of your organic traffic and then you're doing a little bit of ad loading, it is still, you know, fine. Otherwise, it's quite evident and your ad exchange account will get blacklisted sooner or later. Now, to keep this video short, I would end this video, and in the next video, I would explain to you what is the impact of ad loading on the digital marketing ecosystem. Also, how can you use arbitrage safely? So this question would be answered in the installment 2 of this arbitrage and ad loading video series.